account of the events surrounding the Passion of Christ paints a somber portrait of love without limitation, obedience without defiance, and innocence consumed by judgment. Centuries before Calvary, God gave us a glimpse of what was to come. We see a father, Abraham, leading his only son, Isaac, up a lonely, desolate hill. Out of obedience to the Lord, this most precious life, the sole heir to Abraham's kingdom, will be sacrificed this day on an altar of wood. Through incomprehensible heartache, Abraham climbs the mountain, with Isaac close behind, neither understanding what has brought them to this place and time, but both choosing to trust, and with unfaltering faith, they obey.
As our God provides the light.
It was written by Isaiah the prophet, "I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him."
Repent. I say repent. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the coming wrath? Produce fruit in keeping with repentance, and do not think you can say to yourselves, we have Abraham as our father. I tell you that out of these stones God can raise up children for Abraham. The axe is already at the root of the trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire.
Who are you, man?
I am John, but it doesn't matter who I am. For I have been sent to warn all of you to repent from your evil ways and return to the Lord our God.
You have been sent by whom?
I come to prepare the way for the one to follow who will deliver God's people. Repent, I say, prepare a way for the Lord. Change your ways before it is too late.
Are you judging us?
Repent before it is too late.
Repent? From what? We are the keepers of the law. God himself has given us the power to lead his people. You are no prophet. People, do not listen to this man. He is not of God.
He cannot even be sane. Just look at him. Who would you rather listen to, him or us? Go about your work.
Repent, I tell you. The kingdom is at hand. You vipers have abused your privilege, and your power is corrupt. God will smite thee. Repent before it is too late. I baptize you with water for repentance. But after me will come one who is more powerful than I, whose sandals I am not fit to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. He will separate the wheat from the chaff, and those who do not repent from evil will be burned in an unquenchable fire. Come. Repent and be baptized.
Behold the Lamb of God who take away the sin of the world. The bold proclamation of John, who was called the Baptist, announcing the beginning of Christ's earthly ministry, is now a distant voice, a monumental moment lost in the memory of all but those who truly hear the language of the Lamb. The years of ministry have taken their toll on the Master as he approaches Jerusalem to observe Passover for the last time. He sees the crowd beginning to grow as he draws closer to the ancient walled city. He hears their shouts of praise, yet he knows that their adulation is born of celebration and not sincerity. They seek a king, a warrior to lead them from their hopelessness of tyranny which they so hatefully endure. He is indeed a king, but the journey he will lead them on from their bondage to freedom is beyond what this gathering could ever begin to understand. Yet they sense something great in this man who rides in triumph into the holiest of cities. And with their hosannas, they honor what they think they see.
Let's go.
called Jesus has been causing quite a stir wherever he goes. Some say he's been sent from God.
Nonsense. We aren't God's chosen. If God was to send a messenger, it would have been one of us.
Yes, but the people are quite taken by him. They speak of miracles he's supposed to have done.
Miracles?
That's what I've heard. Healings, mostly.
That is ridiculous. He is just a man. He does not have the power to heal.
But the people, they're calling him their king.
A king? This Jesus. What kind of king is he?
That, my brothers, we've got to discover. But the people have embraced him, and that's the problem. We can't let this go on for long. We must take action. Convince the people that they must not follow him.
But how?
We must show that he's just a man. I'm sure we can discredit him. And they will turn when they see that he is no king.
No crown? No throne? Who is this king?
Suffering, heal the sick and raise the dead. I know he's the king. He will reign here someday. I know he's the king. I could never betray. I know he's the king. I know he's the king. I know.
touched me? Who touched me?
Why, there are many people around. Any one of them could have touched you. In fact, I'm sure that many have. Why?
I know that someone of great faith has just touched me. I could feel my healing power flow to them. Who just touched me?
I did, Lord.
Yes, you did. Tell me, why?
I have been bleeding for 12 years, and I knew that if I could just touch the hem of your garment, that I would be healed.
Take heart, daughter. Your faith has healed you.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Go in peace.
Jesus healed that woman. Why, she could have been paid by his followers to say all she said.
He is in faith. He is misleading the people.
But the people believe he is for real. The people believe he has healing powers, and they will follow him wherever he goes.
Then we must stop him now, before it is too late. We can have him arrested.
For what? Talking about God and making the people feel good about their lives? No. If we act against him now, the people will turn on us. We must trap him into discrediting himself and giving us real cause to get rid of him.
Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many will enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few will find it.
Master, we have come far. We know that you can help our friend.
My son. Your sins are forgiven.
Why does his fellow speak this way? He's blaspheming. Who can forgive sins but God alone?
No one. This man is evil. His power is not God.
Why are you thinking such things?
What?
Why are you thinking such thoughts about what I have just said?
We question by whose authority you act.
We question the words you speak.
I ask you, which is easier? To say to this man who is paralyzed, your sins are forgiven, or to say, get up, take up your mat, and walk?
What kind of question is that? You can do neither of them.
That you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. I tell you, take up your mat and go home.
Whose authority do you do this?
I will ask you a question. If you answer me, then I will tell you by whose authority I act. John's baptism, where did it come from? Was it from heaven or from men?
If we say from heaven, then he will ask, why do we not believe?
But if we say from men, the people will turn against us. For they believed that John was a prophet from God.
We don't know.
Then neither will I tell you by what authority I am doing these things. I heal those who have the faith to be healed. I bring sight to the blind who see me for who I am. Blessed are those who see me and then believe in him who sent me. But even more blessed are those who believe without seeing first.
How could anyone come into direct contact with Jesus and not see their Savior? The enemy had truly blinded the minds of the unbelievers so that they could not see the light of the glory of the gospel of Christ. in the presence of signs and wonders that should have swayed the most caustic of skeptics, there were still those who walked away. In the logic of the kingdom that Jesus was presenting, seeing was not believing, believing was seeing.
I did not come to earth to be served by you. I came to serve you. I came to give myself on your behalf.
Why do you keep saying that, give yourself?
I've told you, Peter. My time with you is almost over. Soon I will be betrayed and condemned to death. I have come to be a ransom for the world's sin.
But, Master, we still have so much more to do. We've just begun to make a difference.
And you will continue to, after I am gone.
Without you, our cause would be hollow. The people listen to you, not to us.
They will listen to you, Peter, through the power that I give you. After I am gone, the cause will be stronger than ever.
I don't understand.
You will.
But we need you.
Don't worry, my friend. Though I will be broken, though I will suffer, I will return, and I will never leave you. Remember what I taught you. Remember what you've heard. Remember how I loved you and how I cherish God's word. Soon I will be leaving. With my Father I will be. Never doubt that I am with you. Never fear. Remember. Remember quiet moments, remember days of joy, remember times of victory that no power can destroy. Remember Father's mercy as the blind may see. When you think of those that love you, hear your heart. Remember me. Let not your hearts be troubled. Don't let it be afraid. For I'm going to my Father. Prepare for you a way. Just remember I'm beside you through each moment, through each day. So don't let your hearts be troubled. Through my Spirit you will see. When you think of those that love you, hear your heart. Remember me. So don't let your hearts be troubled. Through my Spirit you will see. When you think of those that love you, hear your heart. Remember. Come with me to pray. The hour is almost upon us. I need you to keep watch with me. Father, we have come so far, but I am frightened. I want to do your will, but this is so hard. Father, everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not my will, Father, but yours. Simon, Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for just 1 hour?
I'm sorry, Master.
Look, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners.
What's going on?
Keep awake, Simon, so that you will not fall.
This presence of prayer that they call King of Kings. We know what we heard and we know what we saw. This heritage prophet in all.
He must be.
Yes, it is now another Father, the Heavenly Father, who leads his only Son, the heir to his kingdom, up a lonely, desolate hill to be sacrificed on an altar of wood. Only this time, there will be no last-minute reprieve, no ram in the thicket. What God did for Abraham, he does not do for himself. It is for the love of each of us that he gives his child to be offered in our place. God removes his hand of protection, and Jesus, the Prince of Glory, obedient unto death, allows the very ones he will die to save to brutally place him on the cross. Forsaken and broken hangs the Lamb of God, alone on the altar.
The battle lines are drawn. The enemy is at hand. As kingdom confronts kingdom, darkness takes its final stand.
deception is his courage. Hatred moves in for the kill. On the battleground of the ages, Golgotha's skull-shaped hill.
There is no God, he will be shown. Save our Savior as he toils on his blood-stained throne.
Death begins to claim him. Forgiveness is his cry. For the sake of all they cherish, God's own son must surely die.
Heaven's legions are withdrawn. God removes his shielding hand. Alone to face hell's fury hangs the Savior, Calvary's Lamb.
Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. It is the isolation of Christ that brings to an end our estrangement from the Father. As Jesus gives himself up in death, the curtain in the temple, shielding the entrance into the Holy of Holies, is torn from top to bottom. No longer will we need an earthly priest to approach the throne in our stead because of the tattered rags of sin that shroud us. We have access to God, clothed in perfect robes of righteousness, purified by the blood of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Exiled from your presence, lost and all alone. wandering in the darkness, no place to call our own. Then love began its journey from a manger to a cross, committed to redeem us regardless of the cost. Now through the torn curtain we enter by your grace into your holy presence, into your holy place. No veil to keep you hidden, the Lamb is sacrificed. We're clothed in perfect righteousness through our Savior Jesus Christ. Blood-washed robes we gather in garments of your praise. We bow before you, Jesus. To you our song we raise. A priesthood of believers, protected by your hand. A royal holy nation, in victory we stand. Now through the torn curtain we enter by your grace, into your holy presence, into your holy place. No veil to keep you hidden, the Lamb is sacrificed. We're clothed in perfect righteousness through our Savior Jesus Christ. Now through the torn curtain we enter by your grace, into your holy presence, into your holy place. No veil to keep you hidden, the Lamb is sacrificed. We're clothed in perfect righteousness. We love you, Lord, and we are blessed. Your holy name we now confess, our Savior.
Therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is his body, and since we have great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and full assurance of faith. So overflowing is his kindness towards us, that he took away all of our sins through the blood of his Son, by whom we are saved, and he has showered down upon us the riches of his grace. astounding news heard that first glorious Easter morn in front of the empty tomb thunders through the ages. It cannot be stopped. It will not be denied. Jesus has risen. He has risen indeed. O death, where is your victory? O grave, where is your sting?
That flame burning brightly that cannot begin, like a fragrant aroma dispersed by the wind.
The good news is spreading, it won't be denied.
Yes, Jesus has risen, he's now glorified. The tomb stands empty, the stone thrown away. The Savior has risen, he's living today. The conflict is over, the battle is won.
And to God be the glory.
Amen.
You may be seated. This evening's performance was professionally videotaped. You've seen these cameras here. And the videos will be on sale at the close of the service. You may sign up for a $20 donation if you'd like to keep this musical and play it throughout the year for your friends. It's available, and you won't be disappointed in the quality of the work that's been done here. We're so grateful for our choir and for Pastor Doug Hunter and for all the hard work that went in to putting this musical together. God is to receive all the glory. God be praised. Thank you, Father, for this evening. Bless your people as they go. Amen. God bless you.